Don't you sometimes wish time could just stop for a moment? That way you could enjoy the small things, like a favorite memory from your childhood, or when you're hanging out with your friends and the fun just seems like it won't stop, so you want to stay in that moment. Sometimes as people, we isolate ourselves because we think we can do everything solo and we think we don't need anybody. And in many cases, doing that, we just push everyone who cares about us. We push away those people who actually, you know, care. Who actually take the time to worry. Who actually take the time to ask you, are you okay? Are you fine? I think it's a normal thing to do. At times, sometimes you can go off the rails. And there's this mindset where if you don't love yourself, how can someone possibly love you? Flawed person you are. And that's what we often think a lot. That we don't deserve anyone, because if we barely like ourselves, we barely have self-love for ourselves, why would someone have love for us? Why would someone care for us? Why would someone take time to talk to us? That sort of thing. And that's kind of what I'm going through right now. I mean, I feel better than how I did a year ago or 7 months ago. Look better, but it feels like there's something missing. It feels like, I can't quite figure it out what it is, but it's something. Sometimes I wake up and I feel like I'm repeating the same day over and over again. I mean, I do different things. I change the pace a little bit. I'm in a different day. But everything just feels repetitive. I eat, I sleep, do a little homework, go to school, get good grades, make my parents proud, or as proud as they can be. Make myself feel a little better, a little confidence, a little productivity here and there. And then, same thing over and over again. I'm just stuck in unproductive states where that's all I'm doing. I'm not doing anything else. I'm not hanging out with people. I'm not socializing. I'm not making new friends. I'm not doing the stuff I'm supposed to do in high school. I also think about what's next in my life. Like, I'm in my junior year in high school. It's been great so far. Met a lot of amazing people. But what's next after that, you know? I have college, the colleges I'm thinking of applying to, I don't know if they'll accept me. What if, you know, this plan doesn't work? I don't really have a plan B. And I'm just thinking if my plan will even work or if it doesn't. And will that ruin my chances of gaining my career or getting it up or, you know, really send it off on my said career? It's scary, but it's also kind of exciting because I want to, you know, make this thing work. I want to have a good career. I want to have a good life. And it just feels so terrifying. Like, I could lose people on the way. I could lose myself. I could lose my mental stability. I could lose so many friendships and relationships I've created over the past like 2 years. Now at times, no one can love me. Now I guess this is why I'm on social media or punching a punching bag. One is because I find rather peacefulness in it. Two is the only way I can express myself freely. And three, it's my way of expressing this hatred I have for myself. Which can be rather scary because I hate myself quite a lot. But we're chilling. We're all good. We're fine, you know? Don't worry about it. And when I try to talk about my feelings, all that comes out is just a cold, airless silence. Because I would hate to feel like a burden to people who would actually give a shit.
I don't want people to worry about me. Because I don't think anyone cares about what I'm going through. I feel like I'm a burden. I can't even bear to look at anyone without breaking down in tears and telling them that I'm not okay. That I'm not fine. Nothing's okay. But I put on a fake smile. I hide my feelings away like a good man should. But I mean, besides all of that, besides all the lies, all the bullshit, all the fake friends, all the fake relationships, all the abuse, I guess you could say I'm fine.
I guess you could say I'm okay and I'm doing all right. I guess you could say I'm hanging in there, pal. Or trying my best here, Dad, Mom, sisters, babe. But generally, I hope whoever is, you know, coming to my TED Talk can feel the same way and say the same, but like genuinely, because I genuinely hope you're okay. Whatever you're going through, you could be going through a breakup, you could be going through a loss of somebody, you could be going through the most stressful situation in school, the most stressful situation in your life, you're at your lowest point in mental stability. I hope you're okay, and I hope you know we'll get better. You know, talk to somebody about it. You're not alone, really. No one is really alone. We can tell ourselves that as much as we fucking like, but we're not alone. There's people to talk to, there's professionals to talk to. If you have a partner, if you have a parent who actually gives a fuck, talk to them. Please talk to them. Because I assure you, you will feel so much better when you walk out of there, you know, accomplished of what you did, of what you talked about. But it will get better. With time, you will grow. You will have emotional maturity. You'll handle things a lot differently when you keep going through stuff like this. And you could take these, you know, these hardships in your life and use them to overcome other challenges in your life. And I think that's something truly special and beautiful. But we're just kids. Some of us are kids trying to get through life. And it sucks that we have to deal with this. For someone else, it could be so much harder. It could be having the most complicated, you know, thing of their life right now. And I just want you to know, you're doing great. You're doing just fine. And I'm proud of you. Now, for some people that might not have heard that in a while, so I'm here to tell you, I am proud of you and how far you have come. I'll be the first to say it, but you will face the odds. And you'll come out a fucking champion. And I know that. I am assured of it. Now I'm going to leave you with a quote. And I truly hope you take it and use it for future hardships. Or just use it in general, to be honest. Learn to put your ego. Car just passed by. Learn to put your ego on the shelf. And remember to love yourself. Logic said it. It's really true. Sheesh. Put your ego on the shelf and remember to love yourself. Logic said that quote. Boy, is it a good one.